So let's take a look at the actual x-ray. I think you'll get a better sense of what we're dealing with here. It's your lungs. You see up here in the corner, that area that...
Mr. Caney, we need to talk about this. There's a lot...
Drinking on the job again. Maybe I'll have one with you.
Roy, you're working later. You and Angelo are visiting Frank Sinkowski tonight. Feds are pressing on the Port Probe. Nobody should get hurt bad. I don't want that guy. Just needs a guy to understand the right thing. Just needs to play for the team, dog. One more thing. No guns.
What?
I don't want someone getting shot over someone's bullshit nerves. Remember that trucker last year? I'm telling you, and I'm telling Angelo, don't let me find out you went in packing.
The guy gonna be there?
He will. I'm sending him a care package. You, tell that doctor about your chest?
He said it was nothing.
Well, that's excellent news. Everything's fine then.
It's fine with me.
With your girl?
Yeah.
Why is she with him?
She's a slut.
Don't say that. I don't need to talk about her like that.
Well, don't talk to me about her. Let's go.
Some of the shit he's done. You gotta tell her?
She knows exactly what she's doing.
You take the front, I'll take the back. For fuck's sake, it's one goddamn lawyer.
We have to move. Come on, let's get out of here.
Move! Move!
Why does men
want to
kill you?
Seems like some kind of setup. Some bullshit over the long run. How'd you find yourself there tonight?
House of Orange, Texas. I knew this girl. She worked for herself. I didn't really know anything about that stuff. So, she was in the phone book. Perfect Choice Escorts. It was like a real business in the phone book. I didn't know.
One of the owners of that real business is a guy by the name of Stan Pitko. You ever meet him?
No. Maybe I
don't
know. Who's that?
There's a guy trying to have me killed tonight.
Three guys came in and just kept hitting this guy until he showed them where something was. And then they shot him. They made me wait. Told me I was next. Fucking happy you killed him. So we got away.
It may take a while for them to figure out what happened. They can't let us go. That guy Stan Ditko, he don't want any noise.
One thing we can do now is get as far out of town as possible and then find a place to lay low. That's what that is. I don't know.
drink.
I kind of want some of them. Like a little pitcher of some of them.
I'm starting to feel like I never needed a drink as bad in my life.
Well, you're young yet. Saved you, be clear on that. Cheer up. You're alive. I'm buying. I'm relaxing. Disgusting. Thank you. Shipping records, mostly. We grabbed them from the house last night. Must be what Pitco is after. You almost ready? We gotta go get another car. Start calling me John. All my new papers say John Veteran.
I'm putting my clothes on now. I'm not trying nothing. I got the message last night. John.
What's that supposed to mean?
What?
You think just because I don't want to fuck you, there's something wrong with me?
What? No.
I'm leaving you here.
What?
You're gonna have to call somebody. I'll leave you a few bucks.
Ah.
But I'm leaving. I'm leaving you here.
Boy. Are you okay?
Now you want to stop.
Somebody owes me money.
That shot?
He's fine.
Who's he?
My stepfather. I shot a wall. He got off luck.
He's kidnapping.
It is not. I'm gonna take care of her now. She's gonna have a better life.
Those people looking for us, you're bringing her into that. You think about that.
All right, baby, we're going on a trip.
Two singles each for a week.
They yours?
Nieces, my sisters.
$387 with tax. You're a darling little girl. How old are you?
3 and a half.
Well, 105 and 106, just right outside. I'm Nance Covington. I'm always here. I'm good friends with lots of policemen. Just so you know. Don't mind what goes on in those rooms.
Appreciate it, Nance.
Good Lord, that's a beautiful little girl. You're the cutest thing I ever did see.
What do you say? Thank you. Back. Can I have a cigarette? I've been thinking. How old are you?
40.
I'm 19. Man, that's nothing, right? No matter what's happened.
That's right. You got your whole life ahead of you. You could start your life over 3-4 times if you want.
What were you doing at 19?
Running playback bets in Louisiana and Mississippi mostly.
How'd you get into that? I think I really kind of fucked things up.
You think about it that way.
I grew up in Orange. Nothing changed out there. Hot, same field, same grass, nothing to do, day after day. I just kept thinking I wanted a real life. If you want to leave, it's okay.
Get some sleep. We'll figure it out tomorrow.
No word on the customer. I just found out.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Offshore rig? Well, we came down here because I was supposed to get work on one for city service.
Mom said she's hungry.
She don't need no sausage. You tell her I said so. Well, I get down here and they say they never hired me. Well, I tell them I got a letter, all right? Well, they tell me the letter doesn't say what it says. And I'm holding a letter. You got another?
You know, she's never been to the ocean.
Hey, brother, want a cold one? I got a long-term deal here. Kind of come and go as it please. I seen a lot of crazy shit, but never a murder. One of the kids finally said something to the owner. I guess it did to her earlier in the day. Where'd you do your time, bruh? Them girls, your nieces?
Yeah, we're on vacation.
Cool. Listen, I was wanting to talk to you. I was wondering if you were looking for work at all while you're, you know, on vacation.
Yeah, what you got, kid?
Got like $20,000, man. This guy runs a clinic on Broadway, places a drug jug. I know, the cleaning lady.
take down doctors.
I am a thief, and I'm a real, real good one. This guy's a sample pharmacy on the premises. I'm talking now benzes, dexes, bifenamine, amphetamine. My mate, she fronted me Polaroids of the layout. 3 days for some mood in Corpus in Houston. 20,000 might be lowballing it even.
What do you need me for?
I need somebody in front of a van to help me move it. I got all the clients, but, you know, people wanting product to more or less scum of the earth. Someone like you at the table, when the deal goes down, things go smoother.
You seem like a good kid, but you got the wrong idea. We're just down for some sun and waves.
You can take care of them girls a lot better with this score. You don't need 10 grand, man?
Not where I'm going.
Thanks for the beer.
You know who this is, you son of a bitch. You took pictures of my lungs. Yes, wait, Mr. King. How long do I have?
I can't say. I just...
How long?
You need to come back in. We need to do a biopsy. You just left.
And we... You son of a quack motherfucker. You want me to come back in? I'll come back in. See about getting a straight answer.
Roy.
I got the address. It's right here.
Wait just a minute.
341 Royal. And your wife know about the gambling?
What are you talking about?
You know how deep in your Pitco, you degenerate prick. I'll come pay you a fucking visit.
Hi there.
Hi.
Good dive.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Rocky.
You on vacation?
Mm-hmm.
Where you all coming from?
He's from Orange, Texas.
And was John from there too?
Thank you.
good. I did a test.
You did.
No, I was on a welding job out on a rig. It's over now. No, I don't want nothing. Catch up a little, just passing through.
I told you I was busy. Okay, it's just for a minute though. But you come inside here, I don't want you out front.
Seems you changed your mind about marriage.
Well, when you meet the right man. What are you doing here?
Well, like I said, I was just passing through, and I was curious to hear how you've been.
Been since when? 11 years ago? The last 11 years have been absolutely wonderful. Yeah. You know, you're not as handsome as I used to think.
Yeah, I actually get that a lot.
You're drunk. You really can't stick around. I'm busy.
Well, I'm not staying. I'm going. I'm leaving town. It's just... You remember when we went to Galveston? You remember that week when you told me about your sister and your dad? Remember? Well, I was remembering we were drunk on mojitos before noon, and we were just scarfing crab meat. We couldn't get the smell off. We were showering off, and it rained, and we went inside, just stayed inside. It was 2 days. It's, you know, fucking.
I'm a dynamite piece of ass.
Yes, you are.
Thank you, Roy. I can't do this all day with you.
Well, I'm just leaving the country, and I was thinking, I believe we had good times.
I was glad when you went to prison. Look, the past isn't real. You, You remember it how you want to remember it. You'd sober up for a week, and then you'd start talking about how things gonna be different, and then you'd be drunk for 3 weeks straight. You made it so that I couldn't be around you without being shit-faced. And you threw me around a little. You remember that?
What'd you ever like about me then?
I don't remember.
There haven't been many like you. For me.
You see this here? It sends an alarm to all those Taliban boys that patrol the neighborhood.
Saying goodbye?
Sure you were.
I'm dying.
Aren't we all? It'll only be for a few hours tonight. I'll have money for you tomorrow.
Well, we really do enjoy her.
What are you up to? How are you bringing money back when you haven't had any here?
I got a job today. At this restaurant on the strip. My hostess, Scarpetto's. I get a tip out.
Yeah, right.
Good for you. We'll take care of him. Of course we will.
Thank you.
You're just drunk, baby.
Hey, do you know where
You know, normally I let folks keep to themselves. But after what happened here, that man murdering his wife, I gotta know what's going on. That gal of yours, she had men in her room twice since you left. She's been putting that little baby off on Dee and Noni. And I believe there was some confusion as to whether you would be back.
Of course it would have paid up. Just kid.
She deserves better than this. You know, I don't know if you're that gal's pimp or not, but you look like hell and you smell like it too. Normally I'd have had you tossed out of here, called the sheriffs. But that little one, she don't need to be put in no system.
However bad you think she has it, where she coming from was worse. You know, her sister's just a girl. I helped out. Bad spot. I didn't know her till a few days back. I just wanted to ride to Texas.
Who are you?
I'm just a guy who tried to help out a couple people and it's brought me here. Listen, they're not my problem. I'll call the sheriff myself, tell him some hitchhiking tramp dropped her kid off on me.
I don't think you're gonna call any sheriff and say anything, but I do think if you were gonna leave those girls, you would've.
I'm looking for the girl. You seen her? Saw you leave. Saw you toss the paper, dug it out the trash. I was just reading along, realized, hey, them girls in that article got the same name as these girls here. 1 + 1, you know. Ain't none of my business, man. I ain't got no desire to screw you over or nothing. I'm just saying, you know, if it come to that.
Come to what?
Listen, if I don't have a partner for that score, I could get busted. Cops come down to me hard, I could break easy. But I could say, listen, y'all lend me some grace and I can give you a murder. I can tell you something about some missing girls. I ain't a rat, I'm just saying, make some money, man, you know? Just come check out the place, man. I'll lay it all out for you and you'll see I'm a pro, man. I'm a pro.
All right. I'm gonna wait till dark, though. People around here probably shouldn't see us hanging out. So meet me in the parking lot down by the Zippy Trip, 8 o'clock.
You're paranoid, Brad. Ain't nobody here gonna know anything.
You want me in, we're gonna start being careful right now.
I'm glad you changed your mind, bro. You're gonna see, I'm a real pro.
on the next block up.
Start whoring the second I'm gone.
Pick up your fucking head!
I want to talk about calling social services, saying some whore about my sister.
You fucking killed someone!
You killed someone!
We are not the same.
Yes, we are.
Tell me about him.
My mom was been around, so it was just Gary and I. And he moved the TV in my room for me. And he was drinking whiskey. So he sat in my room. With me, watching the TV, and then
Carpet bagging Polack motherfucker, this is what your boys were after? Yeah? Well, I got it.
What you want?
$75K, deposit it. It's a bargain.
I think it's a bit much.
Copies go out, Times Picayune, Baton Rouge, originals to the feds, Pitco, it says. Nearly every page, Pitco, 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 Pitco. Get a pen, cause I'm about to hang up.
What assurances do I have?
I guess you're gonna have to reckon my words a little better than yours. It's bothered me out. Yeah, I'm done.
Appreciate how y'all taking to the little one.
She's very special.
Maybe a case that he end up sticking around after I leave. They'll need people to be nice to him. That little one. Needs people looking out for.
What do you mean?
I mean, if I wasn't around, and the little one needed something, I don't know, you'd look after her.
You want to try?
Don't get too excited, but I got something going on that could help you out a little bit. Give you some money. You take yourself a high school degree test. I'm serious. You take yourself a high school degree test, you help. You hire somebody to help you out with the little one, and you go to school for something.
For what?
Learn to do something. You're quick. You do it for yourself. You do it for her. You just do it. Give the two of you a life.
Like her mom. She's thinking after her mom.
My hair's up.
Yeah.
Now.
Now.
My hair's up.
Yeah. What was the game she's playing?
I spy. I spy with my little eye.
So.
She always looks at the thing.
And you.
And so I know. But she gets sad because I always get it.
help yourself, could you? Call me up and making demands, even. It's too bad you weren't as careful when you called the doctor. Remember? He came to me scared shitless. That little whore of yours put up a hell of a fight.
Thank you. We took a look at your lungs. I suspect aspergillosis. We'll do a biopsy to confirm, but this is not life-threatening. Mr. Cady, there are treatment options, and the state will pay.
Mr. Cady, I am speaking to you now as outside counsel for an unnamed party concerned with your recent felonies. Assault, theft, homicide. Quite a list of charges, Mr. Cady. Though I understand you intend to indict other persons to avoid serving time. In other words, you're planning to make it easy on yourself by informing on my client. Naturally, my client's defense would include a body of witnesses to cross-examine, such as Nancy Covington, owner of the Emerald Shores Motel in Galveston, Texas, and a young child, 3-year-old girl. Name I have here is Tiffany Benoit, currently residing with Noni and Dara Ellison at 540 Briarwood Lane, Round Rock, Texas. That's correct, isn't it? Well, there's no need to involve them, of course, if you just serve your time quietly and leave my client out of it.
Was the lady from the hotel a long time ago.
She said your real name was Roy. I hired a man who found your prison records and photos. Took him a while, though. You don't look the same.
20 years ago.
Where do you live?
Austin.
What do you do there?
I do graphic design and advertising stuff, but I'm an artist, too.
Are you married?
Not yet. Maybe soon.
Are you in love?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's good. That you're in love.
He's the one who encouraged me to. I'm sorry. I spent a lot of time and money to find you, and I have questions.
How much do you know?
I remember my sister. A little. I remember us going to the beach. But then one day she just left me.
Wasn't like that. We were going out for the night. We were coming right back for you.
But then you were in New Orleans. You were in prison.
Yeah, I was in a car accident. Got banged up. And there was a warrant out on me.
I don't understand what happened after you both left me. Won't you answer me? Stop putting me off. Stop lying to me. I need to know. Please.
All this time, Dad is your friend. And I'll tell you everything that happened. But I got a condition. There's a storm coming. You gotta get out of town.
What about you? Let's go now. You can go with me.
No. I'll talk to you now. And if I talk, you leave. That's the deal. That little girl in the picture, don't you, and your sister. She's your mother. Don't blame her. She had a hard life, but she did a brave thing once. She didn't leave you. You weren't abandoned. Never abandoned.
Mm-hmm.